Green.
Thank you. भारत के 74वां गणतंत्र दिवस के समारोह पर आप सबको मेरा स्नेहमय प्रणाम और हार्दिक शुभकामनाएं. डियर फ्रेंड्स, ऑन द ओकेजन ऑफ 74th रिपब्लिक डे ऑफ आवर नेशन, माय सिंसियर एंड हार्टफेल्ट बेस्ट विशेस फॉर ऑल ऑफ यू. यू विल रिकॉल दैट ऑन दिस डे 1950 आवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन और संविधान केम इन टू इफेक्ट. द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया is the supreme law of India that lays down the framework that demarcates fundamental political code, structure, procedures, powers and duties of government institutions. It sets out the fundamental rights and directive principles that leads, most importantly, the duties of citizen. It is the longest written constitution in the world. While the sacrifices of crores of Indians in the freedom movement under the leadership of Mahatma Gandhi and many other selfless leaders brought liberation and freedom to us from the British in 1947, that is 76 years ago. It is the constitution that has protected us to preserve that freedom during the subsequent 74 years of independence. It has enabled us today to stand free under this majestic Indian flag. This is not only due to the sufferings of crores of people during freedom movement, but also due to the vision and wisdom bestowed by the fathers of constitution, which guaranteed our fundamental rights as citizens of one country, India. We stand today with great pride in global world, thanks to many post-independence visionaries and architects of the nation, and it is our bounden duty to continue this progress in the true spirit of our constitution. The fundamental rights are one face of the constitutional coin, with an equally important duties being the other face. The duties cannot be as well defined or as much understood by the general public as much as their knowledge about their claims to rights. The elements of duties center on the social responsibility of each one of us. It encompasses recognition and acceptance of the consequences of each action and decision that we make, caring attitude towards self and others, recognition and acceptance of individual and cultural diversity, recognition of basic human rights and actions to ensure the same, the ability to be open to new ideas, experiences and people, understanding of the importance of volunteering in social and community activities. In this context, let me turn to some institutional matters. I was director of IISER Pune for 11 years and now director of IISER Tirupati for past 7 years. I had unique opportunity to build these two institutions from the beginnings. I have seen the admissions of more than 2,500 students to the BSMS program and graduation of 1,000 students or so. The BSMS students joining IISER system are very fortunate to get this opportunity. I must remind all our students that you are all very privileged and very few fortunate ones among millions to get such an educational opportunity. Always, please remember that for each one of you who have joined the institute, there are at least 10 to 15 equally deserving students who have not got the chance. the teaching, research, and other experiences that you get during your tenure here is very precious and enriching. The Indian government and your parents are investing in you to make you competent in discipline that you have chosen and for you to pursue bright career and importantly to become a good citizen. Each BSMS student costs rupees 5 lakhs per year to the government. Please remember this. You cost 5 lakhs per student per year to the government and public money, while you actually pay less than 1/10 of this amount as fees to the institute. So each of your degree costs rupees 25 lakhs over 5 years. Please remember that your education is highly subsidized. So it is important that you make the best use to develop your career and return the public investment on you to the society through your quality services wherever you work later on. Always remember the words of John Kennedy, who during his inaugural presidential address said, "Ask not what your country can do for you, ask what you can do for your country. Ask not what your country can do for you, ask what you can do for your country." These words challenged every American to contribute in some way to the public good. It has great meaning beyond words, and the statement must imprint in your mind at every moment in your life. The first step for you is to read this sentence, replacing the word by institution wherever you are studying. You see the surroundings here, the construction of a massive academic building and lecture halls, the hostels, the laboratory, etc., and see how thousands of laborers are working under hot sun and rain during day and night, risking their health to construct facilities for your education. They are doing it to earn their bread, but without realizing that it would train all future citizens, that is you. A lot of engineers who are supervising their work beyond their call of duty and solving several technical issues in construction. Then there are several staff, administrative and maintenance people who ensure that most things work after the construction. They are not doing their work just to earn their bread, but they do it with passion to the perfection to provide you all necessary facilities, be it food, security, transport, library, computers, classroom, teaching, sports, etc., so that you can concentrate on your studies. Faculty work very hard beyond their job of teaching and research in managing several institutional administration work, the end goal being you, the students, your academics, and mental health. The institute is very proud of achievements of all our students and encourage them in every possible manner to reach their academic goals. We feel greatly satisfied to see you in flying colors, going to other good institutions from here to pursue your future career, win academic accolades, and shape as good citizens. Unfortunately, there is a small section of irresponsible, ungrateful students who exploit the loopholes either in academic or the hostel rules and even damage the institutional property. As we live in a community, we need to exercise collective responsibilities and duties for larger good. This year is a very important one for the institute. We'll be gradually shifting to the permanent campus from our transit campus and vacate the transit campus by the year end. As such, we are working from two campuses with constant movement of students, staff, and faculty between the two campuses, which consumes not only time but also stressful. The relocation would involve unavoidable inconvenience, and we request all your cooperation and understanding. Again, remember, John Kennedy's words modified as, "Ask not what your institution can do for you, ask what it will do for institution." That's a very, very important one. On this day, I want to convey some points and procedures for all the students who will be living in permanent campus. Of course, some of them are relevant to transit campus students as well. Today, we'll be inaugurating the third hostel block called C block. The two hostel blocks where students are now residing are the A and the B blocks. The A and the B blocks were constructed for research students, while the coming up four blocks, C, D, E, and F, are for BSMS students. Based on the current numbers of boys and girls and pending completion of blocks D, E, and F, it has been decided that A and B hostels would be for girls and the completed C block, which we'll be inaugurating today, is for boys. We have a higher number of girl students, and they require both A and B blocks. Hence, all the boys who are now residing in A and B blocks have to shift to block C. As hostels D, E, and F become available, by the end of the semester, girls staying in A and B will also shift to these hostels. When all the advanced lab facilities shift to permanent campus by the end of this year, the integrated PhD and PhD students will be moved to blocks A and B separately for boys and girls. Student hostel facilities are created and built as per the area and specifications prescribed for hostels as per the government norms. All rooms are twin sharing and no separate rooms can be allocated given the constraint of space. Huge amount of public money is invested in constructing these hostels and other facilities, and these are going to be your home for the rest of your time in the institute. I urge you all to please take good care of these facilities and ensure their proper use as you would do for your own home. Kindly do not misuse or damage them. If you damage any facilities, we have no choice but to charge it to you, and we may have to even close those facilities and everyone would suffer. We have seen instances of misuse, deliberate damage, and irresponsible behavior from a small section of students, like scribbling inside lifts, blowing crackers in the lifts, climbing properties of the institution, and violating privacy rules. I feel ashamed to list out several other such acts done by some students. It is easy for us to identify them. We already know them. And strict action will be taken. If you are not taken, don't think that we are not observed it. Strict action will be taken, including asking them to leave the hostel. Such irresponsible students may not be given testimonials or recommendations from the institute for their future career. Damaging institute property is a cognizable offense and amounts to criminal act. Please do not venture into construction areas which are barricaded. There are movement of heavy machinery and cranes in these areas, and it is neither safe nor secure for you. By the end of this year, the campus will be complete, including horticultural and landscaping, and you have the freedom to enjoy all the created facilities. Please remember and be mindful that your primary purpose of staying on campus is for pursuing and completing your academic program, and this should be your priority and focus. You are most encouraged to get engaged in other creative and extracurricular activities and sports to build up your mental character. The government and institute have invested a huge amount of public money in laboratory and scientific research equipment. They must be used with utmost care and diligence under the proper guidance of faculty and lab assistants. The institute can boast of one of the best undergraduate lab facilities anywhere in the country or even abroad. You're all very fortunate to be part of this growing institute, and you may check with past students or alumnus how good it has been for them to be trained in this institute and how it has prepared them for their future. Always be part of the solution and not the problem. I'm highly indebted to all my faculty and all staff colleagues, including administration, finance, engineering, technical maintenance, security, and housekeeping at the institute. The CPWD engineers overseeing the construction work, the construction agency DEC, and the architects ORCOP associates who have all worked as team, sinking their differences to the larger good of the institute and the community. I acknowledge the liberal support from Ministry of Education, Government of India, and the state government in establishing IISER Tirupati. Tirupati is the only city that has an IIT and IISER, and the two institutions are working together and sharing several facilities, creating a new model of academic cooperation. As our tagline says, we create infinite possibilities, limited only by all your creative abilities, with sky as the limit. Our logo summarizes it all, the lotus petals with unlimited growth in aesthetic golden ratio. Thank you all, and Jai Hind.
Namaskar. Today,
It's a landmark day in the history of IISER Tirupati, a Republic Day to be specially remembered and written in golden letters in the annals of IISER Tirupati. Yesterday, we received the announcement about the conferment of Padma Shri Award on our beloved director, Prof. K.M. Ganesh. Applause, please. The award has not come a day sooner. It has come to a person, a humane human, known for his kindness, known for his empathy to people who suffer or have difficulties, and a person who celebrates the success of every other person. An institution builder, 17 years as director, which by itself has been a record. So let us congratulate Professor K.N. Ganesh, our director, on his being conferred the Padma Shri Award. Round of applause, please. We will now conclude the Republic Day functions here and proceed to the hostel building, where we will have our rest of our activities, including the cultural program in the 200-seater auditorium. Thank you very much.